Blue Canyon has been seeing some snow since late yesterday, tallying up to several inches. Brian Hickey has been up there this morning. And Brian, I think maybe a couple of more inches will fall before all is said and done, and it tapers somewhat this afternoon.
You know, at the rate we're going, it certainly looks that way, Eileen. It's great to see all the new snow up here, freshening things up here at Blue Canyon. And as you said, about a few inches of snow here and a little dense, and that's pretty much an indicator that the snow line not too far from here. The chain controls are down the road at Drum Forbay, which is just east of Baxter, and you're going to need those chains all the way up over the top. And right down at the chain control, it's kind of a sleet-rain mix. And then just as soon as you get around the next corner, it switches over to snow. And then here at 5,000 feet, you can see it is dumping here. This morning hasn't stopped since we got here. So good snow up here this morning. Great news for the ski areas. The skiers and snowboarders heading up to the Sierra can have some new snow to go up there and play in today and right on through the holiday, which is an all-important time for ski areas as it's one of their busiest and one of their most beneficial times of the year when it comes to making a little bit of money for the season. So great news for them. And well, we've talked to some drivers who've had less than a great day up here in the mountains this morning. One guy driving 16 hours from Los Angeles. Quite a journey. Listen to his story.
I blew a tire on I-5, so I pulled off the road. I was in the dirt, and we were going to change the tire, and then I backed up and ended up in a gully. So we had a tow truck come out. He towed us, and luckily he had a tire place, and he put four new tires on, and we've been motoring ever since.
And hopefully he'll keep on motoring, but yeah, he had a dead battery down at chain control. Finally got the chains on after having to buy them in Sacramento. Goes to start the car, the battery's dead. So quite an adventure for him, but we saw them there well on their way up the hill. But just know when you're coming to the Sierra, make sure you got a good battery, good chains. You know how to use them, if not the $30 to have someone else install them for you. And you ought to be just fine coming through the mountains this morning, if you're prepared. That is the key. So otherwise, it's going to be a lot of fun. Remember, don't park on those off-ramps. CHP will be out sighting people and towing if you're parked in a dangerous spot, even to go sliding with the family. Back to you.
Yeah, 16-hour drive from L.A. Because of all the hassles.
Nightmare.
That's a long ride. Right now, a check of chain controls, and you will need them. As Brian mentioned, you're going to have to chain up on I-80 just east of Baxter around Drum Forbay. You'll also need to chain up on Highway 50 around Kybers. Highway 70's chain requirements are right around the Blairsden area to Beckworth in Plumas County, way out there. And then also you'll need chains on 88.